Once your internet is set up and you would like to do karaoke, click on karaoke. Okay. The initial setup, it's going to take a few minutes because it's fetching the song list from the cloud and doing comparison to your local drive. Okay, just let it run its course. Be patient. The initial fetching data might take up to 2 to 3 minutes, okay? Once that's done, this is the interface you'll see. This is what we call the karaoke interface. Okay, now if you want to search by artist, please click artist. Okay, remember, it's always going to be initial. For example, if you want to pick Bruno Mars, what you'll do right here, keyboard, you click on B M Bruno Mars. Only the initials, okay? Now see here, you see Bruno Mars. If the artist that you're looking for is not on the first page, what you can do is scroll. Either you scroll or you click on arrows left and right. Or use your finger and drag it from left to right or right to left. Okay. Okay, so we're looking for Bruno Mars. It's on the first page. Let's click on Bruno Mars. Now you see a whole bunch of song titles. The first page, you have a total of eight songs. And 6 pages, so 8 times 6, you have roughly about 48 songs under Bruno Mars. Okay, I'm gonna pick Billionaire. Just click on Billionaire. Now your karaoke machine will start playing the song. Okay, you see on this little screen right here. Okay, you can click on this little screen. It'll expand it. Okay, if you need to search for another song, just click anywhere. It'll go back. Okay, now let's go back to the main karaoke menu. Okay, now for example, I want to find or look for the song called Just the Way You Are. So in this keyboard section, Just the Way You Are, J, just the T, way, W, U is Y, R, A. So now you have it. Okay, so you can click on the song that you like, okay, or you can put a star. So if you put a star on it, that means it's gonna save it to your favorite folder. Okay, let's do that. Okay, and then next time you can just go to your favorite folder and look for it. Okay, so I just put it, I just click on the start. I'm gonna click on the song itself as well. So you see the selected song, selected list will have Just the Way You Are waiting to be played on the next one. Okay, let's go back. Okay, now if I want to play, save that money first, what I do is I'll just click on the top arrow. So this means it's in priority, and it will be saved to the selected list. So let's click on selected list. See, save that money is the next song to be played. Okay, let's go back. Now we did save Just the Way You Are in my favorite, right? So let's click on favorite. Just the Way You Are, it's in my favorite. So next time I'll just go to my favorite folder and look for the song. That would be much, much easier and faster. Let's go back. Okay, now the search button is also very useful. For example, I wanted to look for a song called Sugar. Okay, what it'll do is it'll search for any song title that has the word sugar in it, or any artist that has sugar, the name Sugar within. Okay, let's try Sugar. S U G A R. Why do I want to spell out the whole thing? If I just put in the initial S, I have so many pages to flip through. Okay, pages is right here. Now if but if I don't if it's just one word, I can just spell it out. It'll shorten the search pages. Okay, so I just do left and right and look for, see, it has Sugarland in it. The artist called Sugarland in it. So, or the title called Sugar. Okay, I wanted to sing, I wanted to play by Maroon 5, Sugar by Maroon 5. So I just click Sugar and it'll get saved right here in the selected folder. If I want to see all the cloud songs that's not in my local drive, what I'll do is I'll click the square box right here, right beside the cloud. Just click on it. Okay, see? Immediately, I have a lot more pages. If I unclick, so that means I'm only looking at local drive. Local drive, I have 2,459 pages. If I click the cloud, I have 7,000 pages to flip. Okay. Now I can go, I can just do like this. And then you see some of the songs have the cloud icon. That means the song is not in your local drive, but still in the cloud. What you can do is click the song and then it will start downloading. Okay. Remember, the first year is free of charge. After that, there's going to be subscription fee. See all these songs? They don't have the cloud icon right beside it. So that means it's already in your local drive. Okay. But these songs are not highlighted and has a cloud icon at the end. So that means you can download it and save it to your karaoke machine. Okay, as long as your karaoke machine has enough hard drive space. Okay. Okay, you can go back. Okay. So now, what is the proper way to turn off your machine? This is what here you're looking at is the karaoke interface. We need to exit from karaoke interface back to the Android interface. Then we can turn off the machine. Okay. Now, you see the exit sign right here? Click exit. You want to exit? Yes. Now, this is the Android interface. If you're in this interface, you are safe and ready to turn off your machine. The reason why you always have to go back to your Android interface is if you do download any songs, if you don't go back to the Android interface and turn it off, it will not save to your hard drive. Then that means next time you still have to search for that song and then download it again, and then it's gonna be double the work. Okay. So that's all. Thank you very much.